The following is a presentation of TV 44 Sports.
And welcome to Savage Hall here at the University of Toledo, where tonight WTLW TV 44 Sports brings you another installment of Destination Columbus, the Division II regional title game with the Akron St. Vincent St. Mary Irish taking on the Ottawa-Glandorf Titans. Tonight's pregame is brought to you by Lima Pathology Laboratories, your first choice in laboratory testing. Hi everyone, I'm Mike Shep, here to bring you all the play-by-play for tonight's game. Alongside with our color commentary is Mark Shine. St. V comes in at 22-1. Ottawa-Glandorf is 22-3. And Mark Shine, a special treat for the fans tonight. We're not only going to see the best and most well-known team in the nation, but without a doubt, the most well-known player in the nation.
Well, certainly we are, Mike, and a big challenge for the Titans today to play this type of game against this type of team. We are going to focus on number 23, LeBron James. As you said, the best player on maybe the best team in the state. His legacy precedes him. We know he's very talented. We know he's probably going to be an NBA player a year from now. So we're going to focus on number 23, LeBron James.
Now for Ottawa-Glandorf, their second straight year in this regional final against the same opponent. And, Mark, they also have a very fine player who's been the centerpiece of their team this year.
Well, we are going to focus on number 50, Tim Pollitz. Certainly everybody for the Titans has to play well today. But we're going to focus on Tim because the big guys inside are going to have to rebound. They're going to have to defend. They're going to have to score some down in the post. So we're going to focus on number 50 today.
Okay, folks, the stage is set. A sellout crowd on hand here at Savage Hall for what will be a basketball happening. Division II regional title, Akron St. Vincent St. Mary and Ottawa-Glandorf. And it's coming your way next on 44 Sports. Our pregame report tonight has been brought to you by Lima Pathology Laboratories, your first choice in laboratory testing. Tonight, Destination Columbus has Akron St. Vincent St. Mary going up against Ottawa-Glandorf. Tonight's game brought to you by WCOIL, your on-call, one-stop computer business. WCOIL, more than just the internet. Call now for a free consultation and good luck to the Ottawa-Glandorf Titans tonight. With Quinn's Paints in Ottawa and Lima and Benjamin Moore Paints, you're sure to find what you're looking for. Tonight's game also brought to you by I Do Windows Window Cleaning. Think spring. On a day like today, think clean windows, residential and commercial. Call for a free estimate, 419-339-3030. And tonight's game also brought to you by the Glandorf Lumber Company. Everyone at Glandorf Lumber wishes good luck to the Titans along the tournament trail. That's Glandorf Lumber in downtown Glandorf. This evening's game also brought to you by Pandora Family Physicians Incorporated. We are proud to be a part of tonight's broadcast and a part of the communities that we serve. The Pandora Family Physicians provide primary care and family medicine at three locations in Pandora, Bluffton, and the Ottawa Medical and Diagnostic Center. Tonight's game also brought to you by Dr. Bryce Musser. Dr. Bryce Musser, optometrist, and his staff wish good luck to the Ottawa-Glandorf Titans in this regional title game. This evening's game also brought to you by Scott Wagner Plumbing and Heating. Call Scott Wagner Plumbing and Heating for big preseason rebates on an energy-efficient Carrier Weathermaker air conditioner. You'll save up to $1,000 right now, and you'll save from now on because you'll save up to 60% on your cooling bills. Call Scott Wagner Plumbing and Heating at 419-876-3199. This evening's game also brought to you by Palpac Industries. Congratulations to the Ottawa-Glandorf Titans on winning the WBL title and the district championship. Good luck in this regional final from your friends at Palpac Industries. Stay with us, folks. Starting lineups in the opening tip coming up next on WTLW TV 44. 1-2 Savage Hall. Tonight, the Division II regional championship will be decided between Akron St. Vincent St. Mary and Ottawa-Glandorf. And right now, the starting lineups are being introduced. Our starting lineups tonight brought to you by Lima Contracting, general contractors and builders in the Lima area since 1961. Lima Contracting wishing good luck to the Ottawa-Glandorf Titans tonight. For the St. Vincent St. Mary Irish, Corey Jones, Drew Joyce, LeBron James, Romeo Travis, and Sion Cotton. They are coached by Drew Joyce. Ottawa-Glandorf goes with Luke Pottis, Kevin Utterbrink, Nick Rui, Eric Pollitz, and Tim Pollitz. And they are coached by Dave Sweet. OG comes in at 22-3. Akron St. Vincent St. Mary is 22-1. And we thank Lima Contractors for sponsoring our starting lineups, general contractors in the Lima area since 1961. Lima Contracting would like to wish both teams good luck in tonight's game. Coach Dave Sweet has his team in a regional final for the second straight year against the same opponent, Akron St. Vincent St. Mary. Last year, OG kind of expected to be here. There we see head coach Drew Joyce for the Irish, his second year with the team. They were the state runner-ups last year. The team that defeated them, Roger Bacon, was tapped out of the tournament today by Dayton Kettering Alder in a low-scoring game down in the Dayton area, 34-29. Our officials for tonight's game, Bob Mangone, Terry Geis, and Joe Safranco. The winning team will be playing Friday afternoon, 2 o'clock. 11 o'clock, I think it is, the first game on Friday, the state tournament against either Canton South or Poland Seminary. Poland Seminary is who Akron St. Vincent's played last year in the state semifinals, and Canton South is the alma mater of our broadcast colleague, Mark Miller.
Canton South finished the year ranked 8th in the state. Poland Seminary was 2nd, so those are two quality opponents playing today in their regional final.
We're about set to go. St. V will be in the green uniforms. They're the road team. OG in the white and gold. Last year's game won by St. V, 79-58. They're looking for their fourth consecutive trip to the state tournament. Romeo Travis wins the draw to Drew Joyce, and we are underway. St. V was dominant in their regional semifinal, defeating Talmadge by 50. OG, a closer game against Willard, winning by 8 points.
Titans start out in their 1-2-2 half-court zone.
And they get it inside to Cotton. Now he works down low to Travis. And Travis stepped in the line. Turnover will go against Akron St. V. Now the story of the game might be unfolding right here when OG has the ball, because St. V's defense has been very intense along the tournament trails. We take a look at Travis stepping on the line with the left foot.
This is one of the things, going to travel out of bounds here. Once the ball is on a dead ball situation, the inbounders cannot move, similar to being on the court in a regular playing situation. One foot's all, just like a regular situation during an on-court during a basketball game.
So the teams basically has changed turnovers there, but OG did not get the ball in. Here's the lob inside to James. James being worked on by Utterbrink right now, and he turns it over. So right now we haven't had a shot taken as St. Vincent St. Mary turned the ball over twice. This is Tim Pollitz, has Cotton on him. Two big guys going up against each other here.
The Irish start out man-to-man. They are giving up 6 points per game less than a year ago and probably against better competition.
And they only give up right around 50 a game. Eric Pollitz with the ball. Nice reversal here, and Utterbrink puts it up. And he buries the three. Kevin Utterbrink gets the ball down, and then St. V turns the ball over for a third time.
Three possessions, three turnovers. Here we see that nice job of setting the feet up from about 22 feet.
And Dominion East is sponsoring our replays tonight. Tim Pollitz brings it down the floor. James anticipated it, but couldn't quite come away with it. Eric Pollitz with the ball. Nice move. And traveling will be called. Just took too many steps that time as Romeo Travis was set up, and that's what the St. V defense will do to you.
Yeah, we see he skidded just a little bit as he did his ball fake, and that was the call.
So the score remains 3-0 off the basket by Kevin Utterbrink. So far, St. V has not gotten a shot off. This is their fourth possession. Corey Jones with the ball right now. Gets it back to Drew Joyce. Drew Joyce, coach's son, going to Akron on a basketball scholarship along with Romeo Travis. Corey Jones couldn't get it. Romeo Travis with the rebound. Again to Jones. He adjusts the shot. That is short. Rebound controlled by Nick Rui. So two chances that time from three-point range for Akron, and they couldn't connect. This is Tim Pollitz inside. He couldn't get it, and we have a rebound foul called against the Irish.
I think they got Drew Joyce pushing Pollitz from behind as he went in for the rebound. We see the spin move as he beats Cotton. Well, Travis comes over to help. There's the push we saw right there as he went up for the rebound.
If that's a matchup tonight, Tim Pollitz is going to be able to get around C.M. Cotton. There's no doubt about that.
C.M. Cotton is a good athlete. He's an Ohio State football recruit, but at 285 pounds, he's not going to be able to guard Pollitz one-on-one on the perimeter.
Foul's called against Cotton. Drew Joyce, the coach, politicking for a charge there, saying that Pollitz had his off arm outside, but the foul will go against Akron St. V. It's Tim Pollitz being checked by Cotton again. LeBron James is guarding Luke Pottis right now. Turnaround here by Rui. In and out. Romeo Travis the rebound. Travis is rebounding. Hurt Ottawa-Glandorf a lot last year. Corey Jones the skip pass here to James. James will bring it out to the corner. Jones and James once again. Pottis is on LeBron right now. Joyce gets it back to Sion Cotton. This is Corey Jones with it. And there's another sloppy pass inside. Eric Pollitz comes away with the turnover. Turnovers plaguing the Irish here in the early going. Pollitz puts the shot up but won't go. He gets his own rebound. Eric Pollitz puts his team up 5-0.
Well, you know, Mike, last year at halftime, this was just a 9-point game, so Titans have some ideas they can play with these people.
And there's a foul before the shot by LeBron James. So this will be a non-shooting foul. Luke Pottis.
See the follow-up.
Follow no one there
shot.
For St. V to rebound. And last year, rebounding was one of the areas that Akron St. V dominated against Ottawa-Glandorf. Inbounds pass here to LeBron James. Puts the shot up, and he is fouled. LeBron James goes to the foul line. Tim Pollitz called for the personal. And we'll take another look at our Dominion replay.
Well, you got to wonder about that when the principle of verticality says it's your floor from the floor to the ceiling, even if you're up in the air. And there was some body contact down low, but as LeBron misses the first shot.
LeBron James, a 72% foul shooter, has scored over 2,000 points in his career. And he will get one more from the free throw line, averaging 31 points per game this year, and that's well wide of the mark. Rebound out of bounds. It's off of Romeo Travis, and we'll go over to Ottawa-Glandorf. So we've been almost 3 minutes into this game, and Drew Joyce has seen enough. He wants to take a 30-second timeout. Play has stopped on the floor. Right now, OG leads it 5-0. And welcome back, everyone, to tonight's contest being brought to you by the Ottawa Medical Center. Doctors Deller Hotmeyer, Leah Iden, Jeff Iden, and Steve McCullough, along with the staff at the Ottawa Medical Center, proud to support this broadcast and proud to be a part of the communities we serve. Our doctors are available for your family's medical needs by calling 419-523-0012. I wonder how often Akron St. V has taken the first time out of a game this year.
Yeah, and how long has it been 3 minutes into the game and they haven't scored?
So OG getting ready to inbound. They get it to Eric Pollitz. The Irish press the whole floor, but they get it down to Tim Pollitz here. Tim Pollitz with a little spin move inside. And it's up and in.
Right over Romeo Travis.
Tim Pollitz with the deuce. On the soft roll that time over Travis, and it's 7-0, Ottawa-Glandorf. Drew Joyce, nice penetration, disses off. And a foul's called as Romeo Travis was fouled in the act of shooting, and Drew Joyce created that with his move on penetration. Take a look at the Pollitz basket.
Spin move by Tim Pollitz.
Well, that's strength there. Pollitz had a double pump, but he still got it to go, and here's Joyce with a nice penetration move.
Yeah. Foul down low.
Romeo Travis is a 53% foul shooter, and right now the Irish are 0 for 3 from the foul line. This young fellow is headed for the University of Akron to play basketball.
Well, I think, Mike, in the case of the Titans here, when you're the underdog, and I would assume they are here today, you need to get off to a good start. Stay in the game as long as you can, and they've done that so far. Turnover.
And the pass is deflected. Irish come away with it. LeBron James, jump stop jumper in the lane, won't go. And a rebound controlled by Tim Pollitt. So the score is 7-1. Akron still without a field goal for the first 3.5 minutes of this game. Rui was open momentarily. Rui inside. He gets it up over the rim. Nick Rui with the aggressive move. Then down the floor we come, and Corey Jones loses the handle. Ball's loose in the deck, and OG comes away with it. 9-1. Ottawa-Glandorf by 8. They're the much more aggressive team thus far. Eric Collins takes the shot. It's too long. Tim with the rebound, and he puts it up in. Tim Pollitz makes the score 11-1. Right now, the St. V looks a bit shell-shocked. Out to Drew Joyce. He passes up the three. Corey Jones is short with it. Rebound Utterbrink. He gets it down the floor here to Luke Pottis. Pottis on the lob, and it's too tall for Tim Pollitz. Nice idea that time, but it was over Tim's head.
He had Tim there. He just threw it a little bit high.
And one thing this has also done, the Ottawa-Glandorf is in this game. Crowd is in this game big time.
Yep. Tim Pollitz just takes the ball and goes right over Romeo Travis.
11-1, the 10-point lead is with Ottawa-Glandorf. Drew Joyce gets it inside to Romeo Travis, and LeBron James puts it down. Nice pass that time from Travis, and it took over 4.5 minutes for St. V to get their first field goal. And that is Luke Pottis with the three. Luke Pottis from the outside, his first basket. And it's 14-3. Ottawa-Glandorf has the lead with under 3 minutes left in the quarter. James gets the ball outside here to Corey Jones. Back to Drew Joyce. LeBron James on a little follow-away shot. Called against Akron on the rebounding.
I think Cotton pushed in the back that time. We're going to see some substitutions for both teams.
Now Craig M's getting ready to come into the game for Ottawa-Glandorf. Willie McGee is into the action along with Brandon Weems for the Irish.
Saw Tim Pollitz make the entry pass or entry dribble and then cross-court pass, setting up the three ball there to make it 14-3.
One thing I really am impressed with is Ottawa-Glandorf's aggressiveness in this game. They're not the least bit tentative against this mega-talented team.
They just forced St. Mary's to change their press. They got out of their full court 1-2-1-1 and went 2-1-2, more than three-quarter court.
St. V trying to double-team the ball a bit. And that's Tim Pollitz. He couldn't get it to go. The rebound tipped and controlled by Craig M. Right now, OG beating Akron to the ball when it's loose. Eric Pollitz with the ball, and I think he traveled again. One too many moves that time for Eric Pollitz.
And one thing, Mike, that both coaches will remind their players, it's a 32-minute basketball game, and certainly the Titans have started out very well, and they need to continue that, but there's a lot of time left in the game.
Over 2 minutes left here in the first quarter. Akron St. V with the ball held to one field goal left thus far, a dunk by LeBron James. Right now, Akron St. V ice cold from the outside. They've taken three or four threes and have not connected. Drew Joyce gets it out here to Weems. Now this is LeBron James. He's cut off along the baseline. The skip pass here. And Romeo Travis down low gets it back to LeBron, and he puts it in.
That was really, really well done. The pass cross-court, first ball by James, and then down to the block to Romeo Travis, and then James on the cut to the goal, receiving the pass back.
And James is just lightning quick, just sliced right through the defense right there. Then a sloppy pass here. But Tim Pollitz, an exceptional job of keeping his dribble, then taken away. And Romeo Travis jams it down. Well, the turnover cost Ottawa-Glandorf right there. And OG wants to take a timeout. Play is stopped on the floor. Our score is Ottawa-Glandorf 14 and Akron St. V 7. tonight's action brought to you by W. Coyle, your on-call, one-stop computer business. W. Coyle, more than just the internet. Call now for a free consultation, and good luck to the Ottawa-Glandorf Titans tonight. This game also brought to you by Quinn's Paints. With Benjamin Moore Paints, you receive quality paints in a choice of many colors. With Quinn's Paints in Ottawa and Lima and Benjamin Moore Paints, you're sure to find what you're looking for. Tonight's game also brought to you by I Do Windows Window Cleaning. Think spring, think clean windows, residential and commercial. Call for a free estimate, 419-339-3030. Tonight's game also brought to you by the Glandorf Lumber Company. Wishing good luck to the Titans in the tournament trail. That's Glandorf Lumber in downtown Glandorf.
Great timeout by Coach Sweet. Momentum has started to change, and he wanted to make sure he got his team resettled for the last minute here of the quarter.
And we are in the final minute right now. Tim Pollitz, inside-outside action. Utterbrink thought about a three. Now he gets it to Eric Pollitz. Eric Pollitz with a nice spin move. Now on the baseline, he splits the double team, gets the ball back. Boy, those Pollitz boys are strong. They can get the ball back. They do that so often, and that makes it 16-7.
Mike, you mentioned Ottawa-Glandorf's aggressiveness. A lot of teams would have played last shot of the quarter with momentum changing. Not the Titans. They came out and attacked.
They lead it by nine now. Under 30 seconds left in the first quarter on the Ottawa Chevy Ole scoreboard. James has it in the corner. Now a good pass inside here and a skip pass across the lane, and Romeo Travis is fouled. Well, you're trying to cheat to the ball side, and Romeo Travis comes in from the weak side, and he's a load down low as well at 6'7", and he goes to the free throw line.
See that cross-court pass by Willie McGee. He had the steal right before the timeout that set up the dunk, and then the pass cross-court that allowed that foul to take place.
Pottis has committed his second foul. OG with 14 fouls. St. V has committed three, and Romeo Travis is at the foul line. Youngster had an excellent game last year against OG. He gets two shots here. Romeo Travis with four. He and LeBron James have done all the scoring thus far for Akron.
Pottis is going to sit down with his two fouls, and Craig M. comes in to take his place.
Well, OG uses the bench quite extensively. And Romeo Travis now with five in the game, and this also gives Akron a chance to set up the press. It's a seven-point lead with the Titans now. Under 20 seconds left in this first quarter. Eric Pollitz gets it to Nick Rui. And a foul is called here. It's going to go against Willie McGee. Trying to overplay and cut Utterbrink off on the sidelines. Or excuse me, Rui on the sidelines. But they commit the foul. McGee's picked up his first, and 14 fouls. As we take another look, right there's the bump.
There's the foul by McGee as he's trying to dribble out of trouble in that corner.
10 seconds left. This is Eric Collins with the ball. Gets it to Utterbrink. Now we're down to 5 seconds to go. OG needs to pull the trigger. Nick Rui with it. Rui has to force one up, and it doesn't go in our first quarters in the books. After one stop, an exciting atmosphere here in Toledo. Our score is Ottawa-Glandorf 16 and Akron St. V 9. Tonight's game brought to you by Pandora Family Physicians. Proud to be a part of tonight's broadcast and proud to be a part of the community we serve. The Pandora Family Physicians provide primary care and family medicines at three locations in Pandora, Bluffton, and the Ottawa Medical and Diagnostic Center. Tonight's game also brought to you by Dr. Bryce Musser, optometrist. He and his staff would like to wish the Ottawa-Glandorf Titans good luck in tonight's game. And this evening's game also brought to you by Scott Wagner Plumbing and Heating for big preseason rebates on energy-efficient Carrier WeatherMaker air conditioners. You'll save up to $1,000 right now and save down the road with up to 60% savings on your cooling bills. Call Scott Wagner Plumbing and Heating, 419-876-3199 in Ottawa. Mike Sheff and Mark Schein from Savage Hall. 16-9, OG has the lead, and they have the ball. We're underway in quarter number two.
Willie McGee goes to Tim Pollitz. Right here's the matchup. Pollitz a little too quick for Sia Cotton.
And it's out to Eric Pollitz as Tim Pollitz fell out of bounds after making that pass. And LeBron James tried to come up with a steal that time.
Well, he plays center field right now. He's looking for people to trap, and he's looking for loose balls to steal.
And a turnover there. The trap worked that time for St. V. Weems brings it up into the front court, gets it to LeBron James. Great no-look pass to Adams. Well, that was all set up by the turnover. That makes the score 16-11.
And a foul at midcourt.
And the foul will go against Akron St. V. Weems is called for the personal. This is the Dominion replay right here. Travis with another jam off the pass from LeBron James. And we're now at a 5-point lead. Our stats are brought to you tonight by United Bank Shares. The big edge there is rebounding for the Ottawa-Glandorf Titans at 8-2. And also, the St. V struggling from three-point range. They've made 200 threes this year. They shoot a lot from the outside. Bottas is back in the game with two fouls, and you can see that the Irish have picked up their defensive intensity.
Yeah. Tim Pollis is going to get a little break. He went down at 7:09.
And the ball's still loose. There's a scramble for it. No whistle yet. There's a jump ball there somewhere. There has to be a jump ball or a foul there in that melee somewhere.
I tell you, Mike, it looked like there were several reach fouls on that situation, but they're going to call a held ball, and you see the scramble here. Boy, it looks like Luke Pottis got fouled several times trying to get the ball out of that trap.
Well, there's going to be guys open off that trap, and a technical foul is going to be called here against Dave Sweet. He's very upset with that call.
Well, I tend to agree with him there. I know you don't like to get those technical fouls, but that looked like a situation where there could have been something called down here and wasn't. It's going to be two shots and the ball for the Fighting Irish.
So off that melee where Luke Pottis was surrounded by three green jerseys just reaching for the ball, they ended up calling a jump, which could have very easily been called a reach-in foul. Drew Joyce becomes the first player to score for St. V as we take another look. First player to score except for Travis and James. And
there's a reach.
There's another reach.
And there's another one right there by Joyce.
Yeah, remember they hadn't blown a whistle up to that point. Drew Joyce, an 80% foul shooter, gives his team their 12th and 13 points to make it 16-13.
The ball was going to go to Akron anyway on the held ball situation, so.
Possession arrow went to Akron St. Vincent off that scrum.
Yeah, now we're going to decide whether the technical foul allows them to keep the possession arrow or not, or whether the possession arrow should switch because of the held ball. Likewise, the officials are reminding Coach Sweet that once you get a technical foul, you must stay seated through the course of the ball game, and that really takes away some of your effectiveness here because here, players and coaches sit a long way away from the center of the court.
Now Coach Drew Joyce is talking to referee Bob Mangone about something. I'm not sure what. They got the benefit of that call. And I think we got things ironed out and we're ready to go.
Well, so far the scorekeeper has left possession arrow to Akron St. Vincent.
Well, I think they have to inbound the ball. Don't they switch it then?
We'll see what happens.
Well, it still hasn't been switched yet, so.
So maybe the technical foul overrides that.
And maybe that's what the discussion was about. But on that jump ball, they pointed to Akron St. V with a possession arrow, so they're going to come out the winner two different ways off that situation. Romeo Travis with the ball. Skip pass into LeBron James. James inside, puts it up and in. Well, when he gets the ball that close to the basket, he's almost impossible to stop. That makes it 16-15. So all the scoring here in the second quarter done by Akron St. V. Nick Rui with it.
And all their points for Akron St. Vincent are point blank.
That's Eric Pollitz. Basket counts with the foul. Eric Pollitz inside. Thus far, the Pollitz boys are playing without any fear whatsoever. They're taking it right to the Akron players like this sequence here.
Right here we see the ball fake up in the air, and Travis actually bumps him twice on the arm, and one of those two got called and made field goal and a chance for a free throw.
Romeo Travis called for his first foul. Eric Collins at the line. Attempt is too hard. The rebound controlled by St. V. They have Marcus Johnson into the game. He's a freshman. It's 18-15. Ottawa by three. Just over 2 minutes into this second quarter.
Still nothing on the perimeter for Akron St. Vincent. Everything has been a layup or a dunk.
And it's a team that's made 200 threes on the year, shooting 40% from the three-point range. That's exceptional. LeBron James has 56. Drew Joyce has 46. Corey Jones has 60. The youngster just gave up the ball. Drew Joyce will take a three. Well, Joyce has the first three of the game for Akron, and they've tied it up at 18.
It's the third different press that Akron St. Vincent's rolled out. Now it's all man-to-man and contained.
Tim Pollitz working against Romeo Travis, Craig M inside. Nick Rui in the tall timber gets it to Tim Pollitz. A little bit outside his range that time. LeBron James the rebound. Working in the open court. Gets it to Travis. That won't go. James has the rebound, and he's fouled from behind. Offensive rebound is one of the things that Akron St. Vincent did very well last year in the game. And James gets this offensive board on our Dominion East replay, and he was fouled off that sequence. And Tim Pollitz is called for his second.
Called number 24, Nick Rui, on that one.
So James at the line to shoot two.
Well, I think maybe not.
I think it was on Tim Pollitz.
I think you're right. I thought the official flashed 2-4 at the scores table, but apparently not.
One more coming up here for LeBron James. James now with eight, and Akron St. V has their first lead at 20-18. So they take their first lead some 11 minutes into this ball game. Tim Pollitz is out of the game right now. And
no, we got both of them back in.
Okay. Thank you.
At that dead ball situation.
And a foul is called here, I think.
We've got Drew Joyce.
Okay, Drew Joyce is called for the personal.
It's 1-1.
And it will be 1-1 now for Ottawa-Glandorf. Joyce called for his second.
And interestingly enough, Mike, they just switched the possession arrow just now, so we must have been correct what you said earlier, that the held ball was given to Akron St. Vincent, so now we just now switched the arrow.
Well, they did that awfully late. You're supposed to do that right off the inbounds,
yes,
off the previous possession. Travis has the miss by Eric Collins.
Last year, this was a problem when the game got away from the Titans in the third quarter, missing some free throws that were important.
Now St. V now has the lead. They were down once 14-3, but now they have the lead by two, 20-18. Skip pass here, and Utterbrink comes away with it. Kevin Utterbrink brings it down the floor, and he was fouled. It's called on Corey Jones. And a two-shot opportunity here for Kevin Utterbrink.
Six turnover. Kevin Utterbrink just ran that one down. And then must have been a little bothersome as far as hitting the back of his hand as he released the ball.
And second miss in a row for the Ottawa-Glandorf Titans.
I think they're 0-for-3 from the line right now.
Shoot 65% as a team, 62% as a team from the free throw line, which is a real healthy mark for a team with such a good record. And they're 0-for-3 in the last three attempts. Luke Pottis with the rebound. It doesn't go. Now Hermiller's into the game. He puts it up and in. So Nathan Hermiller with the aggressive move that time, and he will go to the free throw line. He'll have a chance for the three-point play. That foul was called on Romeo Travis. That will be his second.
Coach Sweet's reaction there in a very positive way. Need to make a free throw here, 0-for-4.
And the shooter's bounce goes to Hermiller, a much-needed basket and three-point play.
Nick Rui takes Hermiller's place. He gets a real rousing welcome from his teammates and coaching staff.
21-20, look at some of the huge crowd here from Ottawa-Glandorf and Putnam County for this game this afternoon. OG has the lead back midway through the second quarter. Off play here, James couldn't tip it. That pass was a little too tall even for him.
Yeah, but I think Pollitt's really bothered that. He had enough body on him, he couldn't jump cleanly to the basketball.
And Nick Rui on penetration, and a foul's called before a shot attempt. Once again, the aggressive attitude here by Ottawa-Glandorf is paying off, as they're not being the least bit tentative in the offensive set.
See, number three got the foul early rather than the attempted block.
That's called on Corey Jones. Nick Rui at the free throw line. He's a 68% foul shooter. Double bonus time for OG the rest of the way. And Nick has 3 points.
Here's a lob, and as you can see, just enough body on that he could not cleanly catch it. And that created the seventh turnover, I guess it is, for Akron St. Vincent.
And one more coming up here for Nick Rui. Well, OG continues their struggles from the foul line. They're two out of their last five. 22-20, they have the lead. Under 3:40 remaining in the first half. Division II regional title game here on Destination Columbus. Drew Joyce, catch and shoot. Drew Joyce down with 8. He has 2 threes here in the quarter. Irish back in front, 23-22. Pollitz loses the handle. And it comes out here to Weems. Weems has a block. Goes against Hermiller. Boy, OG did a great job of hustling back that time. It looked like the Irish were going to have a free lane to the basket with Brandon Weems, and instead Hermiller was able to get back, and they called him for a foul. Let's take a look at our Dominion replay.
Well, that's one of those that's kind of automatic. You're up in the air, and everybody's hanging, and you come down with your arm. That's kind of an automatic call, whether there's contact or not.
And Brandon Weems is at the free throw line, the subject of a Rick Riley column in Sports Illustrated. When Brandon started the game for LeBron James, when James had to sit out during the whole throwback jerseys episode. Weems is an honor student. Here at Akron St. V, he's going to get one more from the foul line. So he can put his team up by 2. Brandon Weems has his first point.
Official timeout here. We're going to discuss something.
Right now, the Bob Mangone at the scores table. And I think they're having trouble with this possession arrow about who exactly has possession. This has become a bone of contention here in this first half.
Well, that's who they're talking to, and they have now given possession arrow back to Akron St. Vincent St. Mary's.
Well, I wonder if the technical foul, that's what that whole thing stems from. And Coach Sweet asking for an explanation.
And deservedly so.
Saw that it was switched, and there he explains it to Coach Sweet, who nods his head, and I think we have it ironed out finally. At any rate, 22, excuse me, the Irish have the lead. Ottawa-Glandorf with the basketball. Nick Rui's called for steps. Mark, when you're getting ready to stop your dribble against this team, you better know what you're going to do with it.
Well, what he thought he had was some contact on the foul, and we'll get a timeout by Coach Sweet.
30-second timeout called by Coach Dave Sweet. And we'll remind you that tonight's game is being brought to you by W. Coil, your on-call, one-stop computer business. W. Coil, more than just the internet. Call now for a free consultation, and good luck to all area teams. Tonight's game also brought to you by Quinn's Paints. With Benjamin Moore Paints, you receive quality paints and a choice of many colors. With Quinn's Paints in Ottawa and Lima and Benjamin Moore Paints, you're sure to find what you're looking for. Tonight's game also brought to you by I Do Windows. I Do Windows window cleaning. Think spring, think clean windows. Residential and commercial. Call for a free estimate. 419-339-3030. Tonight's game also brought to you by Glandorf Lumber Company. Everyone at Glandorf Lumber Company wishing good luck to the Titans on the tournament trail. That's Glandorf Lumber in downtown Glandorf. Well, Coach Sweet just took the timeout, his second of the game.
Coach's timeouts were both 30s, just enough to get his team relaxed and settled and leave those 30s for their, leave the full timeouts for the second half.
St. V operating with a two-point lead right now. We're under the three-minute mark. Drew Joyce gets it to Weems. Weems penetrates a little bit. Joyce will take a long three. And that is too hard. Tip rebound, out of bounds. And I believe controlled by Akron.
I think they said Eric Pollitt hit it out of bounds. He and Romeo Travis battling for the basketball.
Was too tall. Turnovers have been a problem for Akron in this game.
They're eighth. Ottawa-Glandorf with 10 right now.
And Hermiller double-teamed right away in the corner. Gets the ball to Rui. Underneath, shot blocked away. Rui gets the loose ball. Still being fought for, and it comes out to Utterbrink. Eric Pollitz has it. Pollitz gets it out here to Nick Rui. And Rui was fouled.
Charge.
Oh, they call a charge on Nick Rui. And that time he knocked down Willie McGee, so the foul will go against Ottawa-Glandorf. Nick Rui called for the foul. That's the eighth team foul against OG, the first on Rui.
He was there, but that wasn't any more of a charge than the one we saw earlier in the ballgame that also went against the Titans at the other end of the court.
Final 2 minutes of this first half unfolding.
A very important 2 minutes, I think, for the Titans. They've played so well this half. They want to stay in contact here heading into halftime.
Now they get the ball down low, and LeBron James puts it in on the follow. That time, Hermiller was trying to keep him out, but that's an impossible matchup right there. 26-22.
Size, strength, and jumping ability.
Hermiller takes the three. It's too hard. The rebound controlled by Romeo Travis. Down the floor we come, and that's a traveling call against Brandon Weems. Is that time he didn't have a clear idea of how to get rid of the ball after picking up his dribble?
No. Here you see LeBron just going up and over Hermiller twice.
James with 10 points in this game. He is the leading scorer, but really hasn't been the major factor that one might think off the pregame hype. But OG, once led by 11, right now they trail by 4 as we approach the final minute of this first half. Utterbrink inside to Rui. Nick Rui puts it in. What a presence he's been along the tournament trail.
Nice job of getting back defensively by the Titans.
As Akron rushed the ball down the floor, this is Weems with the three. It's too hard. Eric Pollitz drags down the rebound. So it's a two-point game right now. OG has the ball. We're under 50 seconds remaining. Let's see what the Titans decide to do. Trailing by two, it's going to be awfully hard to milk the clock against this defense.
There's a reach foul.
That's called against Willie McGee, and it's two shots coming up for OG, but not a bad proposition for the Irish. OG is struggling from the foul line.
Well, and I think Willie McGee tried to make something happen where we were getting close to a five-second count, and he really could have just stayed in a little better defensive position. You see Rui go strong to the glass with a ball fake and score.
And Eric Pollitz connects. One thing you see the St. Vincent kids really try to do, Mark, is to cheat a little bit on defense, come up with a quick steal so they can get a breakaway at the other end.
Well, they've forced 16 turnovers a game. And what they do then is just take those things and go in transition. Tim Pollitz is going to take probably the rest of the half off, at least if it's defensive possession. He may come back for offensive possessions. We get it tied at 26.
Eight points for Eric Pollitz. Luke Pottis will come out of the game. He has the two fouls. Craig M is in for him. And we're tied up at 26 with 38 seconds remaining here in the first half.
Great 30-second timeout by Coach Sweet to get his team reorganized and get the score tied here.
Ottawa-Glandorf pushing out their defense a little bit. We're under 30 seconds now. Drew Joyce is holding on to the ball here. The Irish are going to play for the final shot. LeBron James down low. Gets it back out. And this is McGee with it. Now they get it to LeBron James at 5 seconds to go. The skip pass here, Corey Jones. Drew Joyce pulls it up for the three. That is short of the mark. And our first half is history. It's been a good one here at Savage Hall. After 16 minutes on the Ottawa Chevy Ole scoreboard, it is Ottawa-Glandorf 26, Akron St. Vincent, St. Mary 26. Akron St. Vincent, St. Mary, Ottawa-Glandorf tied at 26 in this Division II regional title game. And we have our statistics for you, which are brought to you tonight by the Ottawa Oil Company on our pregame, on our halftime report. And we'll take a look at the Irish, 6 of 11 from two-point range. OG is 8 of 18. Both teams have made two threes. The free throw edge to Akron St. Vincent St. Mary. Rebounding tonight to Ottawa, which is somewhat a surprise. And both teams have been plagued by turnovers, 9 and 11 respectively. Leading scorers in the game, LeBron James has 10 for St. V and 8 points for Eric Follett's in this game. Let's take a look at some of the action from the first half, Mark.
Well, I think this first basket by Utterbrink is what got everything started. At this point, it was 0-0. The tip had just taken place. And giving us that three ball for Ottawa-Glandorf certainly gets them started out right in the basketball game. And then I think in the second quarter when Drew Joyce hit his two threes, one of which we see here, that was really key because everything had been on the interior up to that point for Akron St. Vincent.
So once again, it is a tie game here at halftime. Now, folks, remind you, Crestview and Marion Local, they have made Destination Columbus a reality, and we'll be bringing you their semifinal games next week, as long as we can get the communities and everyone involved to help with sponsorship and support of the broadcast. And stay tuned to the station for upcoming information on that. On Monday night in Sports Forum, we're going to have Dave Ross from Dave Ross Media down in Shelby County, along with Tommy Usher from the Lima News to discuss the state tournament and sports of all sorts, along with your phone calls. Once again, our halftime score here, we are tied at 26. The halftime report brought to you by the Ottawa Oil Company. To the University of Toledo, where tonight's game is being brought to you by the Ottawa Medical Center. Doctors Daryl Hotmeyer, Leah Iden, Jeff Iden, and Steve McCullough, along with the staff at the Ottawa Medical Center, proud to support this broadcast and a proud part of the communities we serve. Our doctors are available for your family's medical needs by calling 419-523-0012. Tonight's game also brought to you by WCOIL, your on-call, one-stop computer business. WCOIL, more than just the internet. Call now for a free consultation, and good luck to all area teams. Tonight's game also sponsored by Quinn's Paints. With Benjamin Moore Paints, you receive quality paints in a choice of many colors. With Quinn's Paints in Ottawa and Lima and Benjamin Moore Paints, you're sure to find what you're looking for. Tonight's game also brought to you by I Do Windows Window Cleaning. Think spring, think clean windows, residential and commercial. Call for a free estimate, 419-339-3030. Tonight's game also brought to you by the Glandorf Lumber Company, wishing good luck to the Ottawa-Glandorf Titans in this game tonight. That's Glandorf Lumber in downtown Glandorf. And we would like to thank all the sponsors who've helped make these broadcasts of Destination Columbus possible here on WTLW TV 44 Sports, your hometown family station.
Well, you know, Mike, I like to look at body language when teams come out of the locker room at half. Ottawa-Glandorf bounces out of the locker room full of energy. They came out with about 3 minutes to go in the warm-up period. Akron St. Vincent come out quiet, subdued. I don't think LeBron's even walked near the floor to take a shot during warm-ups. Went over and kind of cleaned his shoes off and sat down. I think this next 2 minutes, very, very important for the Titans. It's going to be St. Vincent St. Mary's ball out of bounds. OG needs a stop. They need to keep going because sometimes the worst thing that can happen to a team is to go to halftime. You lose some of that momentum. You lose some of that adrenaline. You stop and think about what you did. And sometimes you come out just not in the same frame of mind as you were when the basketball game started. So very important 2 minutes for both teams, but I think particularly for the Titans.
Well, Akron St. Vincent St. Mary has destroyed most of their opponents this year. They've won 14 of their games by 30 points or more. They have had a couple close games during the season, but really none as of late. So, of course, they're probably used to pressure operating in a national spotlight all year. They're probably somewhat surprised to be in a tie game here at halftime. The Irish have the ball. We're underway in the third quarter. LeBron James with it, tries to penetrate inside. Corey Jones.
Yeah, he's moved to almost a point guard position to start the half.
Well, James has 56 threes, and of course he can get the shot up over anybody at any time. Drew Joyce for three, and he hits another one. Well, Joyce has 11, third three of the night for Drew Joyce, the coach's son.
And that's why they move LeBron out there, because that puts Drew in that corner where he likes to shoot from.
29-26 our score. Eric Pollitz, the ball inside, trying to work it back out. Nick Rui with it. Tim Pollitz working well away from the basket. Now OG will set up the offense right in front of their huge student section. Eric Pollitz, a nice drive. He can't get it to go. Tim Pollitz, the rebound, and he's fine. Boy, that kid is strong. And he managed to be hammered there and get that ball up on the board.
Well, look who he gets it up against. He gets it up against Cian Cotton, who's about 285 and a football recruit.
At Ohio State, we take a look
right
at our Dominion
through him
replay.
And also through Romeo Travis.
And that's who they called the foul on. That is Travis's third. That's much more of a factor than if Cotton had been called for the foul, because Romeo Travis, a very active player underneath for the Irish. And, once again, Ottawa-Glandorf struggling a bit at the foul line, and 0 for 2 right there. And a steal here by Luke Pottis, and he is fouled. The aggressiveness once again by Ottawa-Glandorf paying off.
What a play by Luke Pollitz.
But only 4 out of 9, so that right now OG is 4 out of 11 from the foul line.
Just wrestled the ball right away from Joyce, went up against Cotton and got fouled. The Titans need to make a couple here.
Cotton just committed his third, and Luke Pottis is at the free throw line. Luke now with 4 in the game. He's a 70% foul shooter, a part of that very successful OG football team that won a co-championship in the Western Buckeye League and participated in the playoffs. In and out there, LeBron James the rebound. And it's now 29-27. The Irish by 2 with the ball. We're just underway in the second half. Replay.
Boy, when you look at the number of times the Titans have tried to attack pressure with a lot more contact than that, that's a pretty lame foul there.
And James once again passing the ball off. He hasn't taken a shot in this quarter. He'll take this three. That is well short of the mark. Utterbrink with the rebound. He just passes it down the floor where it's chased down by Eric Pollitz. It was loose on the out-of-bounds line, and Drew Joyce touched it, so the ball is going back to Ottawa-Glandorf. Pottis is going to come out of the game because that was his third foul that he committed. Right there we see it as the ball was out of bounds.
Eric
going
Pollitz,
out of bounds when Joyce
Eric
touched
Pollitz
it.
Did a nice thing because that ball was headed for turnover and he made enough of a play on it to keep it in play. Hand to man for St. Vincent St. Mary's.
And Cotton's working against Tim Pollitz and Tim gets right around him. And a nice help block that time by Romeo Travis. Now the four we come to James. They don't pull traveling on this. Blatant travel that time, and LeBron James has 12, but he definitely took steps on that play.
Next year when he's in that NBA league, that's legal. Here comes another one.
And Tim Pollitz will hold up, and a thunder slam there by LeBron James.
Titans got a timeout.
Timeout called by Ottawa-Glandorf. Play is stopped on the floor. Our score is Akron St. V 33 and OG 27.
with one step and then another step, and we try not to be critical of officials, but they did miss one that time. Big possession for the Titans.
This dude that burned their third timeout. They trail by six, the biggest deficit they face in this game. Just over 2 minutes into the third quarter.
Nick Ruiz posted up. Coach Sweet would like for him to get out of there and open the lane a little bit up for a Pollitz drive.
And Eric Pollitz has the ball right here. He gets around the screen. And a foul is going to be called. And a two-shot opportunity here. I think James has called for the personal. And Eric Pollitz will go to the free throw line. Reaching in with the left hand. And so Eric Pollitz at the line where Ottawa-Glandorf as a team has struggled in this game.
Well, on the board, they put the foul up as Cotton's fourth foul.
Okay, my mistake. I'm sorry. I guess it was called against Cotton. He comes out, and that was his fourth foul. And into the game for him is Willie McGee. So Cotton hasn't really seen a lot of action tonight. He's been plagued by foul trouble.
Well, they're quicker defensively without him. And he hasn't really contributed much on the boards or rebounding-wise, so this is not a bad substitution for them.
33-28, the Irish by 5 points. Corey Jones gets a long pass. Back to LeBron James, who's playing the point here in the second half. He was playing down low in the first half. Corey Jones, they set him up for a three. And Utterbrink comes away with the steal, then he stepped on the line. So St. V will inbound right in front of where we are broadcasting here at Savage Hall.
LeBron James just told him, shoot the basketball. That was my assist, and you didn't shoot it.
Well, that was the storyline of the state title game last year, Division II, when LeBron passed off. And James just inbounded. Under 5 minutes left now in this third quarter. Corey Jones has it down low, gets it back out to Drew Joyce. Now they have LeBron on a wing. Drew Joyce with a nice penetration, and Travis follows. Romeo Travis lays it in to make it 35-28.
Wonderful pass by Drew Joyce to draw the defense to him and then make that pass. Ball's kicked out of bounds by McGee.
Eric Pollitz has LeBron James guarding him right now. James likes to go for steals, then dunk it at the other end. And Tim has it being guarded by McGee. And Mark Schein mentioned that's probably a better matchup for St. V. There you see LeBron going for the steal that time, fighting with Eric Pollitz. Craig M. will take the three. It's way too hard. Corey Jones has the rebound. And I think there's a traveling call there against Corey Jones.
Tim Pollitz was there as he tried to do a bust-out dribble, and he stumbled over his feet trying to avoid Tim. Here's the three, and I think we're going to see the travel at the end of this. Right there.
Tim Pollitz on the reception. He wants to take the shot. Might be a little bit out of his range. James has the rebound for Akron St. V. So the seven-point lead remains with the Irish halfway through the third quarter. Corey James takes that shot. Romeo Travis gets the rebound. Another chance coming up here for Akron. And Jones, let's see if he adjusted his shot, and he did. Corey Jones has hit his first three, and that makes it 38-28. So Akron St. V gradually pulling away in this game. They've outscored Ottawa 12-2 here in this third quarter with 3:35 remaining. Craig M. gets the ball out to Utterbrink, now to Eric Pollitz.
Green team defensive intensity has really stepped up.
And James knocked the ball out of bounds. Akron St. V, their defense is based on help and cheating over toward the ball. They'll leave their men numerous times to try to force turnovers and deflect passes.
Yeah, I'm not sure they're the best team around at individually guarding the basketball, but they do a good job of helping each other going for the steal.
Eric Pollitz couldn't quite get it over the iron. That time, the aggressive move, and I think James has called for this foul. I like seeing a guy going right to the superstar. Yep. Eric Pollitz has lowered the shoulder, knocked James back a bit. And for LeBron, his first foul. more coming up here.
6 of 16 for the Titans at the foul line.
Boy, the things aren't tough enough playing against this team when you have to take advantage of every opportunity. And
6 of 17.
6 of 17, so shooting down in the low, below 40% from the foul line.
And Coach Sweet's going, we're getting what we want. We're getting to the foul line. We're just not making them.
Corey Jones is open, and that's in and out. Rebound controlled by Nick Rui. Nick Rui brings it down the floor, and a blocking foul is called here against Akron St. V. Drew Joyce, I believe, was called for the foul.
It's Drew Joyce's foul.
Nick Rui's done this a lot along the tournament.
This goes right to the goal.
Nick Rui, 68% foul shooter, headed to the University of Dayton to play football. And Rui now with 6 points in the game.
Just 2 points in the quarter for the Titans, both at the foul line. 3 points. Looked at the wrong place on my stat sheet, but all at the foul line.
They have not converted a field goal as of yet. That's been the problem, as Akron St. Vincent has turned a tie game at halftime into what is now a 9-point lead, which isn't bad considering OG struggling so much offensively. Nick Rui now has 7 points in the game, a past Stolle Insurance Hustle Award winner, and we'll be giving that award at the end of the game tonight. 38-30, Akron by 8 with the ball. We approach 2.5 minutes to go in this third quarter. Corey Jones gets it to Travis and a turnover. Turnover goes against the Irish. Let's see if this will be a momentum changer as Eric Pollitz brings it down for Ottawa-Glandorf.
Their 11th turnover in the basketball game.
Inside, Eric Pollitz working against James. He blocks that one. Nice idea, though. And Drew Joyce has to get rid of it. He does so. Travis now over. Well, that could change momentum right there, as OG had a chance at the other end, and Romeo Travis ends up slamming it down to make it a 10-point ball game at 40-30. Nick Drury out here to Luke Pottis. That three is short of the mark. Pottis working for his own rebound. The ball's still loose. Tim Pollitz controls it. Nick Drury does a nice job at chasing it down. Eric Pollitz gets it up over the rim.
1:39 to go in the third quarter before they get a field goal.
That's only an 8-point game. LeBron James can't hit. James has not hit from outside in this game at all tonight. And Eric Pollitz tried to bring that ball in, but he turned it over.
Their 13th turnover. Really was a great idea. A nice outlet pass and a chance to run with it. I thought the ball came up off the floor funny, like it had backspin or something. We see Pollitz's basket here as he gets the ball up on the rim and over.
Now under a minute and a half to go here in this third quarter. Irish lead it by 8 with the basketball. The winning team plays Friday morning at 11 o'clock against Canton South or Poland Seminary at the state tournament. Drew Joyce finds himself open on penetration. Drew Joyce now with 13 in the game, and he was shut out in the first quarter. Back to a 10-point lead for Akron St. V at 42-32. And a foul is going to be called here out front. That will be called against Drew Joyce. I think that's going to be his fourth.
Yes,
that is number 4 on Drew Joyce.
And 16 foul, so the Titans are going to be 1-1 as we see his dribble penetration on the last possession and the floater he puts up in the air that gets the kind bounce.
So Joyce is going to have to come out of the game. Eric Pollitz has taken a seat. Non-shooting foul, though. 16 fouls, bonus time from here on out.
That could be Romeo Travis's fourth foul.
Falls called.
Although, as with most St. V players, when they commit a foul, it's like it never happened. Here you can see the trip right there. And that is his fourth foul, 17th foul.
So two of the main starters for St. V will have to come to the bench. Drew Joyce and now Romeo Travis, each with 4 fouls. And it's bonus time. Ottawa-Glandorf has got to start hitting these foul shots.
Seven of 19 right now, as you said, Mike. They need to get going here at the line because they're going to beat it the rest of the ballgame.
And Tim Pollitz now with five in the game. That's a storyline there that OG is still very much in this game, and Tim Pollitz only with his fifth point, averaging 23 on the season. 42-33, nine-point lead.
Psychologically, big possession because I think you always want to stay in single-digit deficits. And as good a quarter as St. V has had, a big possession.
And a foul's called inside. LeBron James will go to the free throw line. He has not looked to shoot very much at all in this third quarter, playing the point.
Let's see, he's going to take the ball to the goal right here. And that could have been a jump ball, held ball situation, but the official calls it a shooting foul.
James is short on the foul shots. He is a 72% foul shooter. I think that foul was called against Pollitz. That's his third, Tim Pollitz, with 36 seconds left here in the quarter. LeBron James connects for 15 points, leads all scorers in this game. Back to a 10-point lead for Akron St. V. Nick Rui with the ball. Nick Rui dishes off here to Tim Pollitz. Can't hit the little one. Pollitz gets the rebound, and then a foul is going to be called here against Corey Jones on a scary play that looked much scarier than what it was. As an unintentional undercut, Corey Jones, a little bit of a roadblock into Tim Pollitz, but nobody hurt. But a foul is called on Corey Jones, his third. And back to the free throw line goes Ottawa-Glandorf.
You see everybody jumping for the ball, and there's that inadvertent undercut.
And Tim Pollitz now with 6 points in the game, and he's cut the lead to nine with 26 seconds left in this third quarter.
Got a sub for the shooter, too, with his three fouls that could like to get him out of the basketball game for the last 26 seconds of the quarter.
Now Ryan Felke's getting ready to come in. As Tim Pollitz hits both foul shots, Felke reports in. Tim Pollitz will sit down. He's cut the lead to eight.
Of course, he has three 35. Fouls and also could use a break here at the end of the quarter just for rest purposes.
Well, I think we'll see the Irish play for the final shot. Under 20 seconds left. And Travis and Joyce both on the bench with four fouls. Recognized best player in the country. This takes it right now. Said he passes out to Corey Jones for three. That is way short. And the rebound controlled by Utterbrink. Three quarters in the books. Our score is Akron St. Vincent St. Mary 43 and Ottawa-Glandorf 35. And welcome back, everyone, to Savage Hall. Our fourth quarter is about to begin. Akron St. V has the lead over Ottawa-Glandorf, 43-35 in this Division II regional championship game. In that third quarter, Akron St. V had the best of it, 17-9. And they now lead it by eight as Coach Drew Joyce looking on. And right now he's starting the fourth quarter with both his son, Drew Joyce III, and Romeo Travis on the bench with four fouls each. St. V has committed 18 fouls. OG has committed only two thus far in this fourth quarter. C.M. Cotton's back in the game. He has four fouls. Tim Pollitz working against him. That's a matchup that OG's been exploiting the whole game.
There's a steal.
Utterbrink. Almost. But knocked it out of bounds in front of the bench. But a nice aggressive play that time, and it gets the OG crowd involved, and they've cut the lead to six.
You see that last move, just too quick for Cotton, able to hang in the air and score. Stay in their matchup zone.
Ron James, the huge first step, and he lays it in.
That was. He had enough strength in his right hand to cup the basketball and take that long step and score.
That makes it 45-37. And I think a foul is going to be called here on Weems as we... take a look at our stats, United Bank shares, and boy, one of the stories in this game is Ottawa-Glandorf's horrible foul shooting, 9 out of 23. They've taken 9 more free throws than has the Irish, and when you think about it right now, it's an 8-point game.
With that being the 9th personal foul on the Irish, the rest of the basketball game, every foul is a 2-shot opportunity for the Titans.
And Nick Rui is at the line. He's looking for his 9th point. And Rui has once again cut the Akron lead to 6.
Ottawa-Glandorf with some full court pressure.
And they get the ball back to LeBron James. He gets it across the timeline. He can pass over just about any press. 6'8 is the tallest player on the floor. Jones is open up for another 3, and he hits it. That's our designated outside shooter. He had 60 threes coming into this game, his second one of this game, and it's 48-39. Akron up by 9 again, 6.5 minutes left. Eric Pollitz lays it in with the left hand. Eric Pollitz with 13, and it's 48-41. OG's not going to go away. Akron St. V's rarely had to play all 32 minutes in a game this year, but looks like that might have to happen here today for the top-ranked team of the nation, according to the USA Today. Corey Jones gets it inside, and James puts it in. James now with 19. Nice feed that time by Corey Jones. Back to a 9-point lead at 50-41, under 6 minutes left.
He draws everybody to him and then finds his teammate James.
Nick Rui a bit short on that attempt. Sion Cotton with the rebound. So Akron St. V leads by 9. They have the ball. Corey Jones puts that shot up and in. Jones has been a difference. And a timeout called by OG. Play is stopped on the floor. Right now, St. V leads it by 11. Welcome back. A nice shot there. Great shot, guys, of Savage Hall. Sold out for this game today. About 9,000 fans in attendance. And right now, it's an 11-point lead for Akron St. Vincent St. Mary at 52-41. Dave Sweet just took his 4th timeout, so he has one remaining. But he knows that this is a critical stage of the game for his team as they try to stay in and get within striking distance of the high-powered Irish. Pollitz takes it up over James. It doesn't go. Rebound controlled by LeBron James. And a foul is called here on Pollitz. That's only the 3rd team foul against OG. So it'll be inbounded on the side.
Coach Sweet set that play up because McGee or Sia Cotton had been guarding Pollitz previous to that timeout, but Drew Joyce switched over LeBron James that time to him, making the shot more difficult.
Right now, Akron St. V playing without Travis, and also without Drew Joyce. They're still on the bench with the 4 fouls each as we approach 5 minutes left. Sion Cotton inside, throws up a foul that's not answered, and Tim Pollitz has the rebound. Now we have under 5 minutes left. The trips down the floor becoming very crucial for Ottawa-Glandorf as they trail by 11. Pollitz gets it to Eric. Great two-man game there. Nobody underneath for Akron St. V that time, and that makes it a 9-point ball game.
It caught LeBron James watching the action. He was responsible for Pollitz that time and didn't find it.
Corey Jones puts it up. It doesn't go. Rebound to McGee. Gets it outside here.
One of the few offensive rebounds for St. Vincent St. Mary's.
James can't hit that. Tim Pollitz with the rebound. And I think they're going to call him for over back. If that's the case, that is the 4th foul on Tim Pollitz. Non-shooting, though, St. V will inbound.
Those are the kind of things that Tim's gotten away with all season, but this time with McGee being an equally good jumper, he gets called for that.
And I think with the...
There's that last basket. Look at LeBron James watching the play rather than guard his man.
Tim Politz is going to have to exercise some caution here in the last 4 minutes. I don't think Ottawa-Glandorf can afford to take him out. LeBron James hasn't hit a perimeter shot in this game. It's been all dunks and points off penetration. He hasn't taken very many. So if he takes one here. James with 21. That makes it 54-43. Akron St. V up by 11. We're under 4 minutes left.
Titans need to make something big happen, a three-point play or something.
Well, that time Willie McGee committed the foul, and Nick Rui, who has remained aggressive throughout this game, will go to the free throw line.
Should be 10th foul, two-shot opportunity.
And it is, Mark Schein.
Titans need something big. They need to make a couple here and maybe get a steal, go in transition. They need to make something positive happen soon here.
Because you have to think that Drew Joyce and Romeo Travis will be coming back into the game. As there you see Coach
They've been
Drew
lobbying
Joyce.
The coach for this entire free throw shooting opportunity. They want to go play, and he's finally going to acquiesce and let him in.
Two youngsters headed for the University of Akron, as Nick Rui now has 10 in the game, and that makes it 54-44. So Romeo Travis and Drew Joyce the third come back in.
Looks like the Titans are going to go 1-2-1-1 zone press, 1-2-2 zone press. See if they can make something happen, shake things up here.
Corey Jones has it in the open court. And they get it back to LeBron James. Now with 3:35 to go. James in the lane, puts it up, gets his own rebound, and a foul's going to be called. This might have been before the shot was attempted.
Yes, it was.
Okay, and it will go against Luke Pottis, so the Irish will inbound underneath.
Here's the first shot opportunity. As you can see, just up off the floor before everybody else, and the foul was on the floor. That's number 20, Luke Pottis, fourth foul also.
And they set up Drew Joyce, and he hits the three.
You know, he's been making that shot since he was a freshman in the state tournament, right there from that corner.
And he does some trash talking afterwards. Evidently, did, on this long itinerary for Akron St. V, they didn't discuss class or dignity, and if you make a shot, that's what he was supposed to do. Tim Politz hits it. Tim Politz now with 11, and that makes the score 57-46 with 11. Point lead with Akron St. V with 3 minutes to go, and that is Corey Jones. Corey Jones with 10 points. All in this half, he's been a difference maker.
Yeah, I would agree. He averages about 12 a game, and he's done it all in the second half, and it's made a big difference.
Nick Rui answers for Ottawa-Glandorf to cut the lead to 11, 59-48.
Only 14 fouls, so the Titans can foul.
And Corey Jones, once again, he can't hit that one. And the rebound controlled by Ottawa-Glandorf. Nick Rui brings it down the floor, and it's a little bit too far for Tim Politz. Oh, that's an A for effort. They're trying to rush down the floor and get a shot.
Well, the idea was good. Probably that type of pass was the only one he was going to have a chance to make going full speed the other way. Just didn't get it up in the air on the second bounce enough.
So the turnover goes against Ottawa-Glandorf. Drew Joyce brings it down. They lead by 11. James penetrates into the lane. Can't get that one to go. Travis has the rebound. And a foul here by LeBron James.
Well, if you're allowed to jump over people's back and clear them out of the way to rebound, that one was legal.
Tim Collins from outside. That's way too hard. And we have a rebound foul going the other way against Luke Pottis. Akron's not in the bonus yet with 1:56 remaining.
Here's the tip, first of all, by Romeo Travis, and then watch as James come in, just go right over top of Eric Politz.
Luke Pottis has fouled out of the game. His fifth foul, so they're going to bring in Nathan Hermiller. So Luke Pottis, his career will come to an end here today, it looks like. but a vital part of this team. Had 4 points today. Always draws the toughest defensive assignment. He gets a nice round of applause from the huge Ottawa-Glandorf crowd that's here.
I thought the three perimeter players, him included, were the key the other night when they beat Winter.
That was a backwards jam by James. He has 25, including 10 in this quarter. 63-48. OG down by 15. Otterbrink, rebound to Travis. For OG, the tank is just about empty. Corey Jones will take another three. That's wide of the mark. And the outlet pass comes here to Eric Pollitz. Eric Pollitz puts it up and in.
Timeout.
Timeout called by Ottawa-Glandorf. And we'll take a timeout as well. Right now, Akron St. V leads by 13. Ottawa-Glandorf has taken their last timeout. As they trail 63-50. And I think a 5 second call, so they force a turnover off that timeout. St. V couldn't get the ball in bounds.
LeBron James was trying to call timeout midcourt. Nobody saw him, so he had to go explain to the official that I am to be watched at all times, especially by you.
Well, one thing I think is that these kids politic and lobby after every call that goes against them. Rui gets the ball back. And James picks off that bounce pass. So with 1:10 remaining, a reach foul is called against Eric Pollitz.
15 turnovers for the Titans.
Well, that has plagued them, and along with the poor foul shooting, but tie game tonight has been extended to a 13-point lead for the Irish with 109 remaining.
Yeah, 12 of 27 from the foul line against a good team, and that's going to be a problem.
Yeah, they have gotten to the line. That's probably one of the things they wanted to do, but weren't able to capitalize when they got there, and James didn't capitalize on that one. Score remains 63-50. Eric Pollitz brings it down the floor. Gets it to Hermiller, and that three goes. Hermiller now with six in the game, and it's 63-53. Travis puts it down. Travis from James that time, and that makes the score 65-53. Rui couldn't hit it. Eric Pollitz with the follow. Pollitz with 19.
Going to get a reach foul here on that inbounds pass on number 10, Nathan Hermiller.
And it'll be a 1-1 for the Akron St. Vincent squad as we come the other way.
Mike, I think Coach Joyce did something really intelligent at halftime. He moved LeBron James to point guard, and that changed the offensive look as we see the three ball here by Hermiller. It allowed Corey Jones to get loose in the corners for three. It allowed Drew Joyce to get a couple threes when he wasn't in foul trouble. I think that was a really good move on his part. Plus, LeBron got some things going to the basket then from the top of the circle.
I agree, Mark Schein. LeBron James had 10 points in the first half, but he really wasn't all that noticeable. But in this half, he's asserted his excellence and probably did it because of that change to the point position. Drew Joyce now with 17 in the game.
And they are just 10 of 16 at the foul line, so not necessarily a stellar performance by Akron St. Vincent St. Mary's from the line.
And off the miss here, it comes down to Nick Rui. I don't know if Rui's come out of the game at all this game. And a foul is going to be called here, and Corey Jones goes down. He evidently got the worst end of a collision because he went down and doesn't look like he's going to get up.
His own teammate got him. LeBron got him trying to block the shot.
When he brought the left arm down, trying to block the attempt by Rui, I think he whacked Corey James right in the face and head area.
They're treating it like a bloody nose. Let's see here as both teams separate, get away from him.
And, great shot, guys. Appreciate that.
Actually, it's a cut above the eye. Remember when LeBron told him to shoot the ball in the corner earlier? I guess he meant it.
There it is, right there. Ooh. So right now, Corey Jones is being attended to, and he'll have to come out of the game. Mark and I talked. He's been a difference maker in this second half with 10 points all in this half. I think Mark Schein brought up a very salient point, the fact that LeBron James is able to set him up from the point. And most of Corey Jones' baskets, he was wide open when he shot.
Well, you put so much emphasis taking away LeBron James from the top of the circle, and then you try to sag in the middle to take out Romeo Travis and Sia Cotton. And that shows that perimeter baseline jump shot.
Our Stolle Insurance Hustle Award winner today is Nick Rui. And Nick, congratulations, 12 points in this game. And Nick will be invited to our banquet 2 weeks from now and receive a plaque courtesy of Stolle Insurance for his play in the game tonight. Rui's headed to the University of Dayton on a football scholarship, and he brings a football player's mentality to the game. He's always very aggressive, and he's looking for his 14th point.
Well, it's called a Hustle Award winner, and he certainly put a lot of effort into what he did today.
66-57. And then Eric Pollitz with the fouls. He pushed Drew Joyce.
Ninth team foul, so it's still 1-1.
And at the line will be Drew Joyce for Akron St. V. Tim Pollitz is getting ready to come back in.
That's how Drew Joyce got open to receive that pass, and then he's going to get fouled right after that.
A little bit of a push that time, and his dad is still politicking with the officials. It's hard to believe. But 18 points for Drew Joyce. And once again, we'd like to thank our major sponsors tonight, Ottawa Oil, United Bank Shares, Lima Pathology Laboratories, Lima Contracting, all the fine companies in our area that help make these broadcasts possible. We also like to thank our crew. It's been a wild 2.5 weeks. All the folks who do all the technical work behind the scenes.
Mike, I'd like to thank the Titans for giving us such a great show today. Not only today, of course, but throughout the regular season and through the tournament, and they have, I mean, they're going to come up a little short today, but they have really played with a lot of heart today and really played well today.
Well, they've gave Akron St. Vincent St. Mary by far their toughest tournament game. St. V has basically dominated teams throughout the tournament trail. They won by 50 here on Thursday night against Talmadge, which was basically nothing more than a scrimmage for them. And today they looked up toward the end of the first quarter, and they were down 14-3. So they're headed to the state tournament for the fourth straight year.
You know, this is a team also that was, 6-3 at one point and 0-2 in the Western Buckeye League. They came back to get a share of the title and then to play this well throughout the tournament.
Craig Im will come in and Nick Rui will go out. Sold over 3,000 tickets to this game. Eric Pollitz puts it up and in. That's a two-pointer. Eric now with 21 in my book.
Well, I don't know who blew the whistle because the Titans don't have any timeouts left.
Well, evidently, I guess Drew Joyce took the time. He had to take the timeout.
Well, he had a couple of subs he wanted to get in the game for the last 11 seconds, so maybe he did take that timeout.
That's what happened. They just signaled that it was Akron St. V that took the timeout. That basket, it was a two-pointer, made it 69-59. Stay tuned for our United Bank Shares post-game show here on TV 44.
Seniors for the Titans, Matt Boss, Craig M., Luke Pottis, Kevin Underbrink, Nick Rui playing their last games in Titan uniforms, and certainly they've had a great career here.
And Dave Sweet's making sure he gets everybody into the game.
Fans of Ottawa-Glandorf should be very pleased with what their kids have done over the last several years.
So St. V has gotten the players they want into the game. That will do it. So Akron St. Vincent St. Mary breaks open a tie game at halftime, and they will come away with a 10-point victory here in this regional final. Our final score here this afternoon is Akron St. Vincent St. Mary 69 and Ottawa-Glandorf 59. We are back at Toledo, and welcome to our United Bank Shares postgame show. As tonight, the Ottawa-Glandorf season comes to an end, defeated by Akron St. Vincent St. Mary, 69-59. And right now, let's take a look at our final numbers. From two-point range, Akron 19 of 31, and OG 18 of 35. From three-point range, Akron 6 of 17, the Titans 3 of 13. From the foul line, Akron was 13 of 20, OG was 14 out of 29. Rebounding to the Titans, 27 of 24. OG with 15 turnovers, and Akron had 12. Leading scorers in the game, Eric Politz had 21 to lead the way for Ottawa-Glandorf. LeBron James had 25 for the Akron St. Vincent St. Mary Irish. So they move on at 23-1. They'll play Friday morning at 11 o'clock in the state semifinal. OG ends their season at 22-4. A 16-game winning streak comes to an end. Mark Schein, this is the type of game where everything had to go right for Ottawa-Glandorf. They kept this a ball game for about three and a half quarters. Just too much talent. I think what you mentioned, putting LeBron James at the point, was a big difference in this game.
Yeah, Mike, I thought there were three keys to the basketball game. One was the really good start that Ottawa-Glandorf got off to. By having that really quick start, it allowed them to be a three-quarter, three-and-a-half-quarter, four-quarter basketball game. The second thing is when they moved LeBron James to point guard, freeing up baseline jump shooters, something the Titans didn't have an answer for. And third thing, free throw problems for the Titans.
Okay, Mark, thanks. As always, a pleasure. Before I go, a special thanks to all the good folks here at Savage Hall for hosting TV 44 Sports. Stay tuned to the station for potential programming next week for the state tournament involving Marion Local and Crestview. Our final score once again here tonight on our United Bank Shares postgame report, it was Akron St. V 69, Ottawa-Glandorf 59. For Mark and our crew, Mike Shep from Toledo, thanks for watching. Good night.
Oh, water, earth, and sky. The heavens are your tabernacle. Glory to the Lord on high. God who wanders beyond our galaxy. You are holy, holy.
All right, now back to LeBron. It's wild that you can say just his first name and most everyone knows exactly who you're talking about. LeBron James playing at University of Toledo again today. His Akron St. Vincent St. Mary team taking on Ottawa-Glandorf. It's the Division II regional final. LeBron wasn't the only one making a statement today. The OG Titans came to win this thing. First quarter, Tim Pollitz crashing the glass, rebound, layup. Tim scored 11 with 7 boards. OG's up 11-1 later in the first. The other half of the Pollitz twins, Eric, staying with it. He had 21. The Titans up 7 heading into the second quarter. But here comes LeBron James taking over when he wants to. Tied at 26 at the half. Sellout crowd dominated by OG fans, and they're all going crazy. Third quarter, James starting to assert himself. Look out below. Akron's up 8 going into the fourth quarter, and then he's a man among boys. Watch the follow slam right here. LeBron, 25 points, 11 boards. His mom is loving every minute of it in the crowd. OG gave him a battle the whole way. The Titans, the third team to lose to the Irish by 10 points or less. The final, 69-59.
No, I don't think that we took them lightly. You know, they just got up on us. And, you know, they're a great team. They got up on us, and you know, but we a great team, too. You know, we the number one team in the country. We came back, and we got a victory.
We gave these guys a run, and, you know, a run for their money all the way down the stretch, you know. We pushed them. We pushed LeBron. You know, he had to play real hard in the second half. So, I mean, I think we should have a lot to be proud of, you know.